For male reproductive surgery, the commonly practiced surgical technique is the archiectomy. This is called the castration or male castration, and this is the term neutering that is also used for this sort of surgical technique. So this castration is recommended in male dogs for a variety of reasons. The important reason for performing the castration is to control the aggressiveness or aggressive behavior of the dog, and similarly to control the roaming and undesirable urination behavior that is mostly present in male cats. This can be prevented by using the archiectomy. And similarly, there are certain diseases which are involving the male reproductive system, like prostate problems, issues, or neoplastic growth involving the testicular part, involving the prostate region, that is also can be prevented, or that can also be treated by using the archiectomy. So canine castration, this canine castration can be performed by using two surgical techniques. One is called pre-scrotal surgical technique, another is called perineal approach. So pre-scrotal approach for canine castration, this is the most commonly used surgical approach, and it is very much easy to perform as compared to a perineal approach, and sometimes it is not easily approached, and it is a little bit difficult, and it needs more practical background for a surgeon to perform the perineal approach. The pre-scrotal approach, it is further divided into closed open pre-scrotal castration and the closed pre-scrotal castration. The difference between these two approaches is the incision into tunica vaginalis. If the testes, they are removed after giving the incision into the tunica vaginalis, so this approach is called open pre-scrotal castration. But if the testes, they are removed and they are still embedded within the tunica vaginalis, so this is called closed pre-scrotal castration. So to perform the open pre-scrotal castration, as you can see in this picture, incision after proper preparations, pre-surgical preparations, an incision, a small incision of 2 to 3 centimeter long incision that is given at the level of the pre-scrotum, one testis that is grabbed and that is approached toward that side of the incision, and after the incision of the skin, the incision on the testes that is given, the tunica vaginalis that is incised, and the testes, they are pulled out from this opening of the tunica vaginalis. So in the next step, when you have grabbed the testes out, the ligament of the tail of the epididymis that is broken, that is separated, and now the testes along with the supermetacarpal that get free from the scrotum or through the pre-scrotal incision, and this is further divided into two parts. The one part is the vascular part of the supramatic cord, another is the ductus deferens. So in the next step, we have to ligate the vascular cord and the ductus deferens separately, and after they are separated, both these cords, they are ligated with each other. So after double ligation, you can see in this picture, D part of the picture, now the extra part of the supramatic cord that is removed and the testes. So in this way, this operation that is also completed, and this operation that is the most commonly used technique that is used in dogs. For feline castration, the difference is that when you are performing the pre-surgical preparation, the hair of the scrotum that is plucked out completely, and this area is prepared aseptically. So in feline castration, for feline castration, the surgical, the scrotal approach is used. The incision, this is given at the respective testes. Usually this incision that is directed from proximal side to the ventral side,